Obviously, a lot of our algebra class is centered around learning a lot of skill-based things like how to add fractions or how to solve equations or things like that. But ultimately, for what end do we learn these things? Well, ultimately, those skill-based things are designed to help you solve different real-life type of applications. And so, in this video, we're just going to briefly talk about some different word problems you might run into, some real-life application problems that you'll see that are specifically designed for linear equations or that relate to linear equations. So, our goal for these problems is to take some real-life application and solve it using our algebra skills that we've been learning recently. So, the way we do this is by following a few steps. Step one is to read the word problem and see if you can identify what are variables and what are constants. Variables would be things that are unknown, quantities that are unknown in the problem that we're trying to determine. Then once you have your variables identified, next thing you want to do is try to express the problem in terms of some equation. And for most students, this is really the challenging step right here. So as we do examples in a little bit, I'll try to focus on helping you understand how to take the word problem and write it as an equation, because that's really where students struggle. But now, once you've taken the word problem and you've written it as an equation, from there it starts to be downhill, because step number three is to solve the equation. And this is what we're really good at, because again, this goes back to the skill-based stuff that we've been practicing so much. And so once you have it written as an equation, usually we have less trouble actually solving the equation. And then the last step we have to be careful about when dealing with these real-life applications, these real-life word problems, your answer will typically have units like feet or miles or pounds or hours or dollars or something like that, where you won't just have a number like 11, it'll be 11 feet or 7 pounds. Or so on and so forth. So we'll have to make sure that we put the right unit in our answer if our answer really does have a unit. Now, these word problems take a while to unpack, so we're not going to do any examples of word problems in this video. We'll have a number of videos after this one that go through a number of examples. But let me just, at least in this video, give you an idea of what are some examples you're likely to see in your algebra class. These are some popular problems. By far, this list is not every problem you might see, but this is a good list to get you started that are in the vast majority of textbooks. Most textbooks have, to begin with, some problems on consecutive integers. They'll say something to the effect of, the sum of three consecutive integers is 99 or something like that. And they'll want you to find what the three consecutive integers are. So you have to take that word problem, write it as an equation, and then solve it. We have a lot of problems dealing with the perimeter of various shapes, like the perimeter of a rectangle or a room. Maybe you're going to put crown molding in a room or baseboards in a room or something like that, and it'll talk about the perimeter of the room. You'll have a number of problems dealing with complementary and supplementary angles. Complementary basically means two angles add up to 90 degrees. Like 60 and 30 are complementary because they add up to 90, and supplementary angles add up to 180. And so you could have like 170 and 20. Those angles would be supplementary. Another type of problem is they'll talk about a triangle and they'll talk about the angles inside of a triangle. And all these problems revolve around the fact that the sum of three angles, any three angles inside of a triangle, always add to 180 degrees. Another type of problem that's very, very popular are what we call motion problems. We'll actually do a couple of these types of problems. And this is a basic introductory physics type of word problem that relates distance, rate, and time. And the equation that we use here is distance equals rate times time. I won't go into the details here. We'll talk about it in that particular video. And another popular problem I could think of that we see a lot is dealing with combinations of coins, like nickels and dimes and quarters. that add up to a certain dollar amount, and you have to figure out how many nickels and dimes you have and that sort of thing. So anyway, these are some popular problems, and we'll work through the majority of these types of problems. There, you might see some others, but this should at least be a good list to get you started. So jot down these steps for these word problems and have them handy when we actually get into working some of the example word problems.